Jesus came into the district of Caesarea Philippi, he asked the disciples, "Who do people say that the Son of Man is?" And they said, "Some say John the Baptist, but others say Elijah, and still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter answered, "You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God." And Jesus answered him, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father in heaven." May God add his blessings to this word.
I promise this is going to be short. Peter's pledge. How many of you remember saying the Pledge of Allegiance when we started school each morning? I'm not sure what the opening exercises are really about today, but that's what I remember. When we make a pledge, we are promising to do something. When we pledge our allegiance, we promise to stand up for something that we believe in, no matter what the cost might be to us. To be willing to do that, we must really believe in the truth of what we're standing up for. Many patriots gave their lives, the ultimate sacrifice for what the United States flag stands for. As we celebrated our Independence Day, July 4th, yesterday, it reminds us of the time Peter stood up for Jesus. Some people only remember that Peter denied Jesus. And so now we're going to hear the story about the time that Peter pledged allegiance to Jesus. As the scripture tells us, Jesus was on a trip to a secluded area. Caesarea Philippi lies at the extreme northern boundary of Palestine. Perhaps the disciples were on a retreat to relax and reflect on all of the miracles that Jesus had performed. Jesus asked them who people thought he was. The disciples answered that the people thought he was a great prophet of God. This was true. Jesus was a great prophet. So then Jesus asked his disciples directly, "But whom say ye that I am?" This is the most important question we will ever be asked. What are we to think of Jesus? How will we answer that question? How we answer that question will determine where we spend eternity together, either in heaven or hell. I'd like to read Matthew 16:16 again. "And Simon Peter answered and said, Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God." Peter stood up to pledge allegiance to Jesus. He believed Jesus was the Son of God, the Christ, or Anointed One. Jesus said that God the Father had revealed this to Peter. God the Father shows who Jesus is to each of us. If we believe that Jesus was a holy man only, then we never accept the sacrifice